very specific mechanism by which THC works. It in effect disrupts the two main parts of the brain that are involved in giving you the experience of pain, and it really, really suppresses all those activity. It sort of takes the hurt away, basically.
For all the benefits hash brings to Graham, smoking the drug still poses risks. Cannabis smoke contains up to 70% more cancer-causing agents than tobacco smoke.
Of course it's bad for you. Breathing in smoke into your lungs is going to be bad for you, irrelevant of what's in it. Life is a process of dying, as far as I'm concerned, so to give up one of the benefits and joys that I have in living, so that I can live longer without that joy, seems a stupid religious argument.
Graham needs hash to carry on with his life. Maybe one day, in extreme cases like his, controlled and targeted therapeutic use of the THC compounds readily available in hash may gain widespread acceptance in medical and psychological care.
There's a lot of talk in the public media, there's a lot of talk that we need to understand this better. Yeah. But those studies, because of, I think, the tarnished nature of the use of hashish, they've not been studies that have been easy to get funded maybe to in the conventional sort of academic world.
23 states, along with Washington, D.C., now allow doctors to recommend hash for the treatment of a wide range of ailments, or have decriminalized its use. However, the other 27 states still regard hash as a dangerous substance that remains prohibited by law.
Suffer. He sideswiped the telephone pole trying to kill me. Well, we'll move and they light this over. Something in Africa. You got people out killing themselves, making money.
Customers' desire to flaunt their wealth and Ghana's high import duties.
I brought a new car from garage for like $20,000 and paid for $30,000 for duty. Doesn't make sense. So everybody goes for stolen cars, because when the car is stolen, you don't buy it for cheap.
Cheddar operates in Accra, Ghana's capital. He deals with a select clientele who are looking for high-end cars.
The type of people who buy expensive cars are the front and drugs people. So there are more crimes going on, and people are making money from crimes.
Ghana's criminals make their money from internet fraud and drug money, and they want to spend it on big flashy cars.
Some pay the money upfront and sell the car release.
then you get a car for you.
Cheddar's looking for one customer in particular.
I know a person who owns very expensive houses around here. And he made his money through this hard work. And tonight, you'll be in that club. You know, he's going to pop many champagnes.
As a reliable seller of stolen cars, Cheddar gets preferential treatment in the clubs. But he gotta deliver.
Yeah, don't bring me his butt.
5,000 miles away in New Jersey. The cops are trying to mess with Cheddar's supply.
It's always the West African region that we seem to have the largest amount of volume. Mostly countries that have border security concerns, like Ghana, Sierra Leone, Liberia, the Ivory. It's not an easy task.
Detective Sergeant Auclair spends a lot of time at the New Jersey docks.
I just received notification from Customs and Border Protection regarding an examination of a container
He's part of a team of police and Customs and Border Protection officers targeting stolen cars leaving the U.S.
So we're going to verify if the vehicle is back stolen or not.
But searching suspect containers is a big job. And that's what stolen car shippers count on.
They charge you $10,000 to do that for you.
For these criminals, getting cars past police and border protection means working a vast underground network.
They're talking about 15 cars a week, and that's a lot of cars going out of the country, yes. It is a very organized crime. New Jersey is the biggest port, and this is where most of the containers go, and it's very tough for the U.S. Customs to go through each container. So the cars